In the same way as Naruto, Gaara hosted within his body a one-tailed spirit known as Shukaku. The only bonds that Gaara shared with others were shackles of hatred and murderous rage. And in his eyes, combat was only to be undertaken with the intent to kill or be killed. As Naruto fought for the sake of his friend, Gaara fought for himself only. Thus began a confrontation between two shinobi who had endured similar challenges, yet reached opposite conclusions.
I'm gonna crush you, and all your little friends too!
My friends are everything! Protect them to the end!
Yeah! But how? And what makes him so strong.
It's almost unbearable, isn't it? The feeling of being alone. But I have people in my life now who are important to me. I care more about them than I do myself, and I won't let anyone hurt them.
Into his final ounce of strength, Naruto caught Gaara flush on the cheek with a full force blow. But it was not hatred that was behind the attack. It was the sympathy that only one who had shared similar experiences could express.
I know that feeling. I've been there, in that dark and lonely place.
Why do this for anyone but yourself?
Because they saved me from myself, from my loneliness. They were the first to accept me for who I am. They're my friends.
Friends. So that's where his strength comes from.
Knowing well the suffering of solitude, Naruto was able to empathize with Gaara's feelings to a painful degree. And yet, Naruto now had important people in his life who accepted him, so he could not overlook Gaara's aggression. Witnessing the power of love firsthand, Gaara cast aside his bloodlust and departed with the aid of the other Sand Ninja. He left hoping that he too could emulate Naruto one day. The damage caused by Orochimaru's plot to destroy the Hidden Leaf was catastrophic. To recover from this tremendous upheaval, the village was in need of a new leader. That honor fell to the Toad Sage Jiraiya, who was also a legendary Sannin like Orochimaru. Although Jiraiya had been asked to become the next Hokage, he embarked on a journey to find another suitable candidate. Naruto accompanied him on that journey. At that same time, the village received an unexpected visitor. It was Itachi Uchiha, rogue ninja of the Hidden Leaf and member of the organization known as the Akatsuki. Itachi was Sasuke's older brother, as well as his hated enemy. 5 years earlier, Itachi had slaughtered every member of the village's prestigious Uchiha clan in a single night, save Sasuke. Learning of Itachi's visit, Sasuke left in quick pursuit and came upon him just as he was trying to capture Naruto.
Long time no see, Sasuke.
Itachi Uchiha, you're the one person I'll never forgive! Itachi Uchiha, it's just like you said. So bitter, so full of hate, and I vowed to kill you! That's all I live for! Hidori!
This way!
Any connection I have to you ends here and now.
You're nothing but a nuisance to me here.
This way! This way! This way! This way!
What?
This way! This way! This way!
What?
This way! This way! This way! This way!
Take this!
Power!
Itachi Uchiha! Get ready to die!
You're not strong enough.
Sasuke fought valiantly, but the gap in their abilities was insurmountable, and he fell victim to Itachi's genjutsu known as Tsukuyomi. Your hate isn't strong enough. And with those words, Itachi departed, but not before also getting the best of Jiraiya, who had rushed to Naruto and Sasuke's defense.